I said sorry. I was. I shouldn't have said that. I then realized that not only did I hurt her feelings, but I hurt her children's feelings, and I hope they never forgive me for that. Because you never hurt children, and although I am insulted, but my children are tough, so they don't care.
But have you tried to reach out to her?
No, because as far as I'm concerned, if I was her, I wouldn't accept me reaching out to her. That's just the way it is. I never fool myself. When I do wrong, then I do wrong.
Okay, so does this mean, I'm curious, you know, Teddy Boy Locsin on Twitter is a fiery
character. You have to do that as a matter of the medium.
I'm curious now, were there lessons learned after that incident? I mean, you did...
Yes, I keep learning those lessons and unlearning them, because then I keep... suddenly I encounter, you know... how politely can I put this? I encounter less than the intelligence I expect of a fellow human being. Then I blow up. But sometimes I don't. I let it go. I do know this, that using insults is a fast way of getting it off your chest. But on the other hand, explaining it without calling someone out, as you know, and explaining why I should really be calling you an idiot, is actually more effective. But sometimes, well, I'm only human.
Yeah, but then you are also Foreign Affairs Secretary.
Yes, but then so, it was a human being that was appointed, and I was very effective one too. Would you like a completely polite and idiotic Foreign Secretary?
But the choices are bad. It's like polite, idiotic.
No,
that's
no.
Not
the choices are correct, because my my foreign policy choices have been impeccable.
No, I didn't question your foreign policy choices.
Even my behavior is impeccable in every other respect except that.
Except that.
And I'm not going to change that, but I think I should. And I make a great effort to try to change that. But sometimes I will fail. So therefore, this is a warning to all of you out there. I will do my best. But don't push me.
Well, I wanted to ask you, why don't you get off Twitter for a while?
No.
No.
I would want to get out of Twitter, but then I cannot. I have this obligation, which I was inculcated in me by my father, working in the Free Press, that I cannot allow stupidity to flourish. Mm-mm. That when it lies in my power to do something about it, I feel it's my patriotic duty to stop stupidity.
All right. Yeah. Now,
it's the greatest threat to our country.
I mean, I've been hearing talks, and I wanted to clarify this with you. I mean, after Manny Piñol's resignation, and then the president announcing that he could use him for the Mindanao authority, are you staying on as secretary? Have you heard these talks of names being floated? I'm sure.
Well, I'm sure everyone's hoping to get my job and then do a bad job of it. But then, I just wait for the president. But then, so far, the names I've heard are of pretty incompetent people.
So you've heard those names?
Yes, they float around, but not much, I can tell you that. Yeah, principally because they're the ones floating it.
So I'm curious, when you've heard names floated for
some of them are my friends.
How was your reaction? Did you ask the president?
No, why would I do that?
No, do you have plans?
No, why would I do that?
You won't do that.
No, I won't do that.
You won't do that.
No.
Okay.
But I did say something that may have triggered it. When I spoke on DFA Day, I said, all of you oldies, be ready to leave. And when it's time for you to leave, leave. Because I, as I came, so shall I go in the twinkling of an eye. And then I will know. That's it. You know, how come those of us who are chosen political appointees, like Alan Cayetano, they go in, they go out. We've had so many foreign secretaries in a short period of time. How come we can take it? But you old ones, you just keep clinging. Mm-hmm. And you keep clinging and clinging while the young ones below, who have something that the old people don't have. They have energy. They have fresh blood. And they have fresh intelligence. Mm-hmm. You keep sitting on them.
That was your speech.
That was my speech. Time, when it's time to go, go. Which reminds me of the Thai ambassador, the great farewell for me in New York. Everybody said something sentimental. Thai ambassador said, I have advice for you three. Mm-hmm. Know what you can do, know what you can't do, and know when to go. I love that man.
All right. Mm. Last words. I mean, we have a minute to go. I mean, you're all over the news, whether it's on the West Philippine Sea or the cancellation of passports.
Actually, I'm not all over the news. Other people are over the news, especially the fantasists. Well, all I'm going to say is this. Just listen to what, just watch what we do. Sometimes we speak out of turn. But the one thing, when it comes to formal policy, the thing that counts, we never make mistakes. I just don't know how to make a mistake. That's just the way it is. So that's how it goes. Trust me.
On that note, Secretary Teddy Boy Locsin, thank you so much.